I am Christelle from Diabetes Strong, and this is a quick tutorial on how to read nutrition labels. In this tutorial, I'll also be focusing on how to read the nutrition labels with carb counting in mind. So carb counting is really important if you, like myself, live with insulin-dependent diabetes and dose your insulin based on how many carbs you eat. So this video is great for you if you're learning how to count carbs or if you just need a refresher on how to read a nutrition label. So let's dive right in. So I'll be using this low carb cereal as an example. So the nutrition label here, I'll be leaving a copy of that up here in the corner so you can follow along. So this nutrition label is just gonna be an example. Pretty much all the nutrition labels here in the US are set up the same, but you might encounter a dual column nutrition label instead, or a single ingredient nutrition label, but the principles are gonna be the same. First up is serving size. So here in the US, all the nutrition information is based on serving size and not per 100 grams like it is in most other countries. So it's something to pay attention to. It's important because a product might look to you like it's a single serving, but it might actually be two or even more. So always turn the product around, look at the nutrition label and see if it's a cookie that you pick up, for example, is it actually one serving or is it maybe two or more? So if you just want to enjoy one serving of this cereal, you'd have to pour out half a cup or 36 grams of the cereal. So the 7 serving size simply just means how much is there in the bag total. So that would be 3.5 cups, and that's basically just the content of the whole bag. Then we have the total amount of calories in a single serving. So if your goal for reading nutrition labels is weight management, the total calories is a good place to start. However, if you're looking to read nutrition labels for understanding carb counting, you want to continue reading. And now we're getting to the good part. Now we're getting to what those calories actually consist of. So starters, I would suggest that you focus on the 3 macronutrients. So that would be your fats. I would look at the saturated fats as well as the total fats. You want to look at your carbs, and not just your carbs, but also your fibers and your added sugars. And then finally, you want to look at your proteins. If you're looking to reduce your sodium, that is also a good one to look at. But let's break it down using this as an example. So this product has 5 grams of fat per serving and very, very limited amount of saturated fat. Saturated fat are the ones, the kind of fats that are solid at room temperatures, and they usually predominantly comes from animal products. So generally, saturated fat has been considered as being one of the worst offenders when it comes to heart issues and artery clogging. However, some saturated fats from non-animal products, like we see up here, do not have these issues, are generally considered healthy. So the rule of thumb is to go from saturated fats that comes from nuts, from fish, and from plants, and you should generally be okay. And then we have the carbohydrates, or the carbs. So carbs are not just carbs when it comes to insulin dosing. So don't stop at total carbs. So this product has 14 grams of carbs total, but 9 grams of that is actually fibers, and there are no added sugars. Fiber, for the most part, is one of those things that doesn't really get digested. So in reality, for most people, it won't impact blood sugars. So if you take the total carbs, which is the 14 grams, and then you take the 9 grams of fiber and subtract the 9 grams of fiber, you end up with a net carb count of only 5 grams. A lot of people find that they actually need to dose for the net carbs versus the total carbs. If you want to dose your insulin based on the net carbs rather than the total carbs, there's one more thing to think about. So this product does not have any sugar alcohols, but if it did, I would be subtracting 50% of that sugar alcohol content from my total carbs to get to the net carbs. So let's imagine that this product had, 2 sugar alcohols, 2 grams of sugar alcohols. Okay. That means 50% of that's 1. I would also subtract that to get to my net carb. So we have the 14 minus the 9 and then minus the 1. That means that the total net carb count for this product would only be 4 grams. And then we have the total protein content up here. So generally I tend to choose products that are high in protein, and with 11 grams, this product is considered high in protein, and this is all plant-based protein. Now we're done with the macronutrients. Now let's move down to the micronutrients. So that would be your mineral and your vitamins. So say, for example, that you've been told to pay attention to potassium. then you want to definitely check out this part of the label. And finally, let's check out the percentages that you see over here on the right side of the label. Those are the percentage daily value. On some labels, it might just say percentage sign D me. So on each line here in the label, you'll see a percentage daily value listed. So the percentage daily value is based on the FDA guidelines on daily calorie consumption. And because they just have to create a baseline, they base that on a 2000 calorie daily diet. A percentage of 5% or lower of any of the given nutrients is considered low, whereas a percentage of 20 daily value or higher is considered high. The main benefit, in my opinion, about looking at the percentage daily value is that, especially if you buy packaged goods, kind of like this product is, a lot of them are really high in sodium. So if you predominantly are eating packaged food, you might be getting a lot of sodium from your food. And like packaged bread, for example, can have up to 10% of daily value. So if you look at this product, what you'll see is that the saturated fat, the sodium, the carbs, the calcium, and the potassium is considered low because it's 5% or lower. Whereas the fat, the fiber, the protein, and the iron is all considered high. The final thing I look at is the actual ingredient list. So you should be getting all the information that you need from the actual numbers when it comes to managing your blood sugars or anything else. But I do like to look at the ingredient list as it can give a little bit more color to what's actually in the product. This might be the last part of the nutrition label that I read, but if you live with a food intolerance or a food allergy, this is probably the place to start. The list of ingredients, it doesn't just tell you what's in the product, but also how much. Because all of the things as they're listed by weight. So what you see first is what you'll find the most of in the product. So for example, let's say that you go to the supermarket and you pick out a yogurt. So a dairy-based yogurt. The first ingredient should probably be a dairy product. So if it's something else, you might want to put that yogurt back on the shelf. As you can see in this list of ingredients, this product is all plant-based and it's sweetened with stevia and monk fruit. That combined with the high amount of fiber and the no sugar added indicates that this is a low glycemic food. And I can confirm that. I really enjoy eating this and it's fairly soft on the blood sugars. I hope you found this video informative and hopefully it can help you sharpen your carb counting game. If you did like this video, please give it a like below and leave me a comment. Also, if you do enjoy my content, please hit the subscribe button and you'll be informed whenever I post new content. Thank you so much for watching.